Hello, welcome. Thank you for checking out this channel. I'm your host, Palmonia Gordon, and it is my absolute pleasure to welcome you to this broadcast. Today, we're looking at wealth, prosperity, and abundance, and how can we create more of those things in our lives? Now, for those of you who are Christian, please don't shut the channel off. I'm especially speaking to you today. So, how can we become more wealthy, more prosperous, more abundant? When I wrote my first book, Order It, that was one of the first things God revealed to me: the power of your thoughts, the power of your words, and how they impact your actions. So everything I share about revolves around the three things: thoughts, your words, and your action. That's the three things that actually impact your wealth, your abundance, and your prosperity. So if this is the first time you're joining us, welcome. What we do on this broadcast, we share thoughts, stories, and ideas that we hope will inspire and motivate you to give you tools and resources that will allow you to move forward and get even micro steps closer to your goals. We challenge you on this broadcast, so if you're up to challenges, welcome. So, wealth, abundance, prosperity. As I read my Bible and I understand my Bible, I look at people like Joseph, like Abraham, like Moses. Moses had servants. There's one chapter in Genesis when Lot, Abraham's nephew, was taken captive. Abraham was able to arm his servants, 372, I believe, to go to war against three or four nations who had captured his nephew. Now, does that sound like a poor person to you? The reality of it is, Jesus came, he died, which means now we would have access to even greater abundance. But the one thing that was taken away from us was our ability to think. I wish I had set up my board, but doubt erases. I want you to get a pen and paper, and I want you to write $1 million. And then I want you to take a pencil, write it in pencil, take the eraser and start to erase that figure that you wrote. That is how doubt acts. It erases, because the minute you start to doubt that it's possible, you begin to erase the creation and the possibility of that becoming real. So today, in hopes of helping you to build your belief in the possibility that you are meant for wealth and abundance and prosperity, I'm going to encourage you to read a book, a biblical, The Millionaires of the Bible by Catherine Ponder. She shares stories about Abraham, Isaac, Joseph, Moses, and Jesus, and how they were millionaires. Because if you take what they possessed back then in the Bible and you translate it to, you know, current times, they were wealthy. Now, how much of the pie would you like? When I speak to individuals and they say to me, "Oh, I don't want to be rich," I usually ask them one question. What is the one thing that is keeping you from doing what you'd really like to do? What's the one thing that's keeping you from taking care of your family the way you would like? What's the one thing that is keeping you from not going to work? Wealth, abundance, prosperity. So we need to change how we define it. Change our relationship by changing our thoughts, changing our words, and then change the actions that we take. And everything starts with your belief. If you believe it's possible for you, absolutely. And that's what the serpent in the garden took from Eve, her capacity to believe. Did God really say? There comes that doubt. Oh my. So now we forever have taken on that posture. Well, let me second guess. Let me think about it. And you spend so much time thinking about it, you never do anything about it. I encourage you today to take action. Control your thoughts. I'm doing a piece on goal setting. I'm going to encourage you to take that, look at it, and apply it seriously. And let's see the changes and transformation that comes your way. I'm your host, Dr. Palmonia Gordon. Thank you for checking out this channel. Please do join us again on another broadcast as we continue to shift our thoughts, our mind, and of course, the stories we tell ourselves and others. Have yourself a good day.